Hey guys, Liz here. Welcome to The Dream Machine, Chapter 1. I already actually played through the first chapter, and let me tell you something, this game's amazing. They don't seem that long, but like, the puzzles are... The puzzles are really hard, and it took me like... more than an hour to get through it, so I'm gonna spare you that, and we're gonna do this again. We already picked up 3 pieces of wood, a shovel, and a fishing pole, and over here's a lighter. Gonna try and start a fire. This reminds me a lot of that painting from The Static Called My Name, which isn't really a good thing to be reminded. Don't set yourself on fire, idiot. Which isn't really a good thing to be reminded of, honestly. But, you know. It's there. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna try and find a worm, if you know how to use a shovel, you asshole. Soil's too hard there. Okay. Let's try over here. Okay. Let's try it. There we go. Let's look in this hole. Oh, there's a worm. I really, really love the art style in this game. Like, just look at it. It's like claymation or something, I don't know. Ugh, come on. Yeah, this game's gonna be really dialogue heavy and slow, and because as you can see, it's a click and point and click puzzle game. So yeah, the episodes might be long. I might try to, what's this? How strange, there's a piece of paper in the belly of the fish. I might try to actually do one chapter per episode, which might make the episodes run a little long, but I think that way it'll keep the story very cohesive and it'll be cool. But we'll see, we'll see. Here are the trees and the rocks, and there's an X there. So, let's get out our shovel, because that's obviously a treasure map. What's in here? It is an alarm clock. Can't do anything with that. And we're awake. Oh, man. He's so creepy. They're so creepy. Honestly, like... look at him. Blank black holes for eyes. That hairstyle, like, his hairstyle's grown on me. I mean, it's like a sideways mohawk, but you know, it suits him. He's got his guitar over here, his old axe, a bunch of boxes because they just moved in. Furniture should arrive later today, because all I've got right now is the bed. Contains some parental reading material soon to dig into as soon as they're stable. Gosh, he's such a cute dad. He's so into it. And look at this, look how cool that is. You get to like move stuff. Gosh, I love this game. These are creepy. They remind me a little of Furbies, but like, I'm in love. Okay, I'm gonna go over here, move this box. We'll actually get through this relatively quickly, so. Because you know the puzzles already. Pick up the mail. That's his wife. She's lovely. Hello, Alicia. Ugh. I don't know why she's so much scarier than him. Like, maybe her eyes are bigger, or maybe it's her face. Oh, you're awake. Thought I'd surprise you with breakfast in bed. Oh, that's sweet of you. I know, aren't I sweet? You are sweet. You're a sweet person. The shipment hasn't arrived yet, honey. It doesn't have to be a table. Anything square and flat will do for now. Just grab an empty box or something. Of course, darling. Before we do that, I'm gonna run in here and grab the baby oil. and compliment myself in the mirror. Hello, handsome. He is pretty handsome. I mean, once you get past the nightmare. I still don't really know what happened to this guy, the previous tenant. Cause like, I don't know, doesn't seem good. Okay, so, got this. Come on, turn about. This is a little clumsy, but it's better than like, it feels very natural, and I like it. Travis, the previous tenant. Look how cool this is, just like, I don't know, it's just, I'm just really into it. I'm not gonna play a game that I don't think is absolutely awesome. Okay, to whom it may concern, I'm hiding this note in the hope that somebody won't find something going on in something. You know what? I'm not paranoid. Look under the floorboard below the light switch in the bedroom and you'll see what I mean. Whatever that thing is, it isn't mine. And I'm not staying around to find out what it does. Perhaps she'll be able to figure out. Travis, the previous tenant. Does that sound foreboding? Did I pick up the box? Okay. Put it on the floor. Don't put it on the plants. Sweet. Alright, now go call your beautiful wife. Who is carrying another demonic creature. Sounds... yes! Put an empty box in the corner by the windows. First, I'm going to tell you about the note. I don't know if I have to, but what do you think of this note? Skeptical wife. It does sound like a crime novel, honestly, but this isn't a crime novel. I'm not entirely sure what this is yet, actually. But it's called The Dream Machine, so I'm assuming it has something to do with dreams and machines. You do that, honey. Oh, you're such a good couple. You do that, honey. Isn't this magical, honey? Our first breakfast in our new home. Yeah, it could use some candles at the very least. If I knew what box they were in, I'd go get them. But how was it? How was what, dear? How was it for you? Your first night in our new home. Did you sleep well? Felt like a baby. I even slept with my clothes on. I noticed that, but I didn't have the heart to wake you up. Did you dream anything? Yeah. Once I was alone on a small island. What did you do? I started a fire by rubbing twigs together. No, I found a lighter. How convenient. For a deserted island, it seems pretty well stocked. True. True story. That's true. I hadn't thought about that. Then what? Then I caught a fish. Your bare hands? No, I had a pole. Aw, poor fish. That's almost cheating, isn't it? It was him or me, basically. Then what did you do? I found a note in a fish. Oh wow, what did it say? Treasure map. How exciting. Did you find the treasure? Treasure? I was just about to, but then the alarm clock went off and the sound must have fused with my dream. That's when I woke up. It's strange how the mind incorporates real things into dreams like that. I've read that it does that in order for us to get our precious rest no matter what. It only wakes you up if it thinks you're in danger. It's comforting to know that my mind is looking out for me even when I'm sleeping. What do you think it means? Well, what means? Your dream, silly. I think it means I was just looking at the painting above the bed as I fell asleep, that's all. That ugly one? Yeah. tell me the truth. Standard escapist fare. Moving here and trying to raise a family is going to be the best thing I've ever done. Still sounds like you're viewing it like some grand adventure. Just a dream, Alicia. You're taking it too seriously. Sorry, Victor. Guess the force of pregnant mood swings is strong with me today. And I know it. This is quite a breakfast. How long have you been up? Since 9. I was having a dream, but after a while it turned weird. That's when I woke up. What happened? You remember the caretaker that let us in last night? Yeah, I can't remember his name, though. Me neither. Norton? Morton? Horton? Something like that. He was in my dream. Sounds like he made quite an impression on you. To be honest, he sort of creeped me out. I thought he seemed pretty nice. He was nice in real life. The dream version of him was kind of creepy. Speaking of the caretaker, he still has our dream, doesn't he? Yeah, he said he'd stop by with the duplicate this morning, but he must have forgotten. Better call him, then. Sounds like a plan. I'll go wash the dishes while you give him a call. Do you want help? Stop pampering me, dear. I'll be fine. Her legs are fairly short compared with the rest of her body. Okay, so we've got our address. We've got the real estate phone number. Professor Ninkovich, how may I help you? I could be a call person, guys. Actually, no. I can't deal with people that well. They really impress me sometimes with how they deal with, you know, customers. I'm trying to reach the caretaker. 12 DuPont Crest. We're new in town, so I don't know where everything is. There's no caretaker. His name is Morton. There's a Felix Morton, but he's listed as the landlord, not the caretaker. Yep. Give me his number. Thank you. Nope. That's fine for now. Call Mr. Morton. Morton here. I'm on the second floor. Spare key. He forgot. Okay, he'll be right up. Go tell your wife he called. Yep. Yeah, I just got off the phone with him. Okay. Yeah. I just got distracted seeing you with those rubber gloves on. Alright, so what you doing about? You really want to hear it? It's a bit graphic, considering that you just ate. It is a bit graphic, and if you're weirded out by pregnancy or any of that, you should not listen to this part. I dreamt that I was on a luxury cruise through the Mediterranean. I was on the deck in a fold-out chair being served umbrella drinks. You dreamt that before, haven't you? Yeah, it's a recurring dream. It'll haunt me till the day you buy us that luxury cruise. Haunt us both, then. Anyway, I was sipping my drink on the sun deck when I heard the sound of running water. So I looked around for the source when I noticed the water came from me. You dreamt your water broke? That's what I thought. What happened then? So I'm sitting there feeling embarrassed in front of the crew members, trying to remember to I remember trying to cover my lady bits with a towel. But by this point it's gushing out of me basically, so it's not like the towel is doing any good. I'm sitting there smiling apologetically to the crowd around me when I hear a sound, like a cork popping out of a champagne bottle. When I look down between my legs, this fully dressed little man shoots out of me and flops down onto the deck. As some of the people from the crowd help him up, I see who it is. The caretaker from last night. He gets up, brushes the water from his coat, looks at my private parts, and casually says, "That's the most interesting entryway to date. I'll have to make a note of it in my journal." That's... what an odd thing to say after just... that's really weird, honestly. That's... yeah. That's really weird and somewhat disgusting. Okay. So let's go let this guy in. Hey dude, he's also frightening. Here's the spare key. Thank ya. Yeah, everything's good. For now. That's all for now. Thank you. Okay, good. Bye. Yeah, I'm gonna go down and look for furniture now, I guess. Okay, what was I doing? Right, alright, alright. I enabled the mouse. Jesus Christ, that's a loud elevator. I thought that might happen. You are very old. You're one of the new tenants, aren't you? That's right, I'm Victor Neff. What a cute name. My wife and I just moved in across the hall from you. Well, hello there, young fella. I'm Eddie Jones. I'm the resident senior in this house. Oh, I thought that was the landlord. I seem to be having a problem with the elevator. Sorry if I disturbed you, ma'am. I'll leave you in peace now. That's quite all right. I like carrying other people around me. And about the elevator, you just need to lubricate the hinges a bit, that's all. Will do. Alright, first of all, that seems very dangerous. Second of all, how do you get to the hinges of an elevator? How does that work? Need a key to get to the basement. Let's just go to the first floor. What's this? Window. This is a nice setup. Yo, bud. Hey, Mr. Morton. How's it going? So, I already read this. I'm just gonna tell you about it. His family has owned this place for, like, generations. He's a landlord. He takes care of it, all that shit. There are, like, three other people that live here. Must be the key to Morton's office. Nice, okay. There are, like, three other people who live here. Eddie and two other families. I don't know. It's weird. And then there's the people who were here before us. As you can see here, Willard, Theed, Brittle, Morton Estates, and more. Those are the same guy. Jones, Willard, Theed are the other three. And this is the mailbox of that other guy. There's nothing in there right now. But, okay. Let's go talk to this douchebag. Are you Victor Neff? Yeah, that's me. I got yourself a here, sir. Ready and delivered. So if you'll just sign the receipt right here, I'll leave it in your hands. Excuse me? It's blocking the entrance. You should have thought about the size when you bought it, sir. Really? Quite a common mistake, really. You deliver door to door, like it says here and here in the contract. Technically speaking, this sofa has been delivered to a door. I don't buy that for a second. I think you managed to get our sofa stuck in the doorway. And since you can't get it free, you're just gonna leave it there? You call it stuck, I say it's delivered. Sir. When did you stop caring about your job, man? Helping people move their furniture is my greatest passion, sir. I can just feel this ass, and that's fair. That's fair, honestly. Come on, help me out. I've got a pregnant wife upstairs, and I can't get this free by myself. Well, I guess I could give you this complimentary crowbar. I'm sure a big guy like you will be able to pry that sofa free in no time. Provided that you sign the receipt, of course. Thorough checkup is always recommended before employing someone else's services, sir. God, he's so sarcastic. So much shade. I respect his sass, but I also hate him. Because look at this shit. He can't even get out. He just sits here and takes a nap. Like, what? It's ridiculous. I think I live on the second floor, right? I don't remember. Yep. I hope so. I wouldn't want to walk into random apartment. Alright, let's call Prosernenkovich. Yeah, this Victor Neff. What kind of services do you provide? They also help with furniture. That's all? That's not all, actually. I wanna say something else. Prosernenkovich, call him back. We're gonna be like the most annoying customer ever. Yeah, another question. The movers, okay. I can assure you they're not a firm we would recommend. Nice. Of course, sir. Just check the schedule tomorrow afternoon. Thanks, bud. That's good enough, I guess. People will be able to leave in a couple days. Honey, are you okay? Why did you leave the water running? You okay, babe? You chill? Did you get a creepy vibe off of him? Can't say I did. He still seemed quite nice to me. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm just overreacting about him. Honey, trust your instincts. Trust your instincts. Oh, yeah. I forgot. Okay. I have a crowbar now, which means we can do this. Because this is a shitty crowbar. Jesus, okay. And look in here. Because this apartment is creepy as hell. And we have puzzles. Alright, so I have no idea what this actually is. Nor do I really remember how it goes at all. How does this work? There we go. Sweet. Overloaded the fuse. Yes. Okay. Awesome. We did it, guys. Yeah. Bypass the fuse. What is this? Okay. Let's get out of here. Sweet. Can I use my apartment key for this? Is that what I'm supposed to do? It's been a long time. Okay. Okay. Just gonna take that. And then, there we go. Ooh, what was that? Completely burned it out. And, here we go. If that isn't the creepiest goddamn thing you could find in your apartment, I don't know what is. Just a camera pointing directly at your beds. Wow, look, there's even a tiny little hole there. Didn't notice that before. I don't know. I did what it said on the note and found a circuit board under the floor. After I tampered with the circuit, the painting flew up. What's that behind the painting, Alan? It is a camera, honey. Sorry, but you know, first night in the new house, we probably shouldn't have celebrated so much. It's a hidden compartment with a camera in it. A camera? I mean, somebody was peeping on us while we slept? Certainly seems that way. But who would do such a thing? I don't know. Let's go with previous tenant. Isn't the setup a bit elaborate for that? Why would you write a note leading us to the camera? Doesn't make sense. Let's go with Mr. Morton. Just about to say that. Of course you were, honey. He had access to the apartment. I told you, I got a creepy vibe from the guy. Told you should have trusted yourself. Good girl. And if it was Mr. Morton, that means he found a note left by the previous tenant and tried to destroy it. That makes sense. If it is Morton, if this is some perverted fantasy he's trying to fulfill, I feel so violated, Victor. Yeah, don't blame you, that's really creepy. I think we should contact the police immediately. What do you think? Let's go make sure he doesn't get away before the police arrive. By now he's probably noticed that we've discovered what he's up to. I'll just go down and keep an eye on him until the police get here. Sounds like a good idea. We have to make sure he doesn't get away with this. I'll call the police in the meantime. You do that. Alright. Let's go confront this old asshole. And do what we will. See you later. I'm gonna go beat up some defenseless old men. Well, I wouldn't exactly say that, but, you know. Ooh, window's closed. Where'd it go? Where'd you go, you little bitch? Do I have anything? What do I have? Leave. That's locked. I'm gonna grab this coat hanger. I think that's what I'm supposed to be doing. At least he can't get out the front door, right? Oh wait, no. Let's look through the window again. Then let's go fishing. Super cute. Okay. Now, let's go, Mr. Detective Man. How are you so smart, Victor Neff? Sweet tunes, buddy. My wife's upstairs calling the police. They'll be here any minute. Oh, shit. Oh, hey, chapter 2. The little man who wasn't there. Alright. So I'm gonna end this episode here. Thank you all so much for watching. Leave a like, comment with any suggestions or improvements. We're still new, so that stuff's kind of great. And, you know, you can find us on any social media place. I'll see you later, animators.